Hi guys, Adeposi here, and are you looking for how to build posture when talking to prospects and building your network marketing business or your internet marketing business? Today I'm going to share with you some powerful tips that you can apply to your business right away. And in fact, this actually is a result of a question someone asked me on my email list this morning, and he said he has challenges with getting people to show up for presentations. So after doing the invitation, the prospects don't show up for the presentation, and quickly I knew it was a problem of posture. And you see, the thing about posture is you either have it or you don't. Okay, so stay tuned. I'm going to show you exactly how to build posture and why it's so important for you to have this in your business if you want to create some massive success. So stay tuned, and I'll see you on the other side. We're gonna have some fun today, and I'm actually going to be sharing with you, some very big stuff, okay? And this is going to give you a real mindset shift, and for you, I'm hoping that it will actually show you exactly how to start getting more results. Because you see, the thing is, if you and I apply the same amount of effort, in the same business and even the same prospects, chances are that I'm going to get better results if I have more posture than you. Because network marketing is about leadership, okay? It's a transfer of belief, transfer of enthusiasm about your products or your services or your company. And if your prospects can't see that, okay, they're not going to join you. So at the end of the day, it's not really about the product. It's about if you are the kind of person they want to join, okay? And that's where posture comes into play. So as I said earlier, when you're talking about posture, you either have it or you don't. And the funny thing about posture is that your prospects can smell, can smell when you don't have it. They can smell when you have fear, right? Posture is, apart from network marketing, it encompasses all our relationships, our communication. So even if you're trying to, get a girl that you like, to go on a date with you, or you're trying to get a new business partner, or sign a new deal or a contract, or you're trying to speak in front of an audience and convince them about some points that you're sharing with them, if you don't have posture, you're definitely going to find it very hard to get people to believe in what you believe in, and actually get them to take the required action that you want them to take. So you see, posture, it's not just about looking tough, okay? Because that's like the natural thing when, when you tell someone you need to get posture, you need to have posture. They like to create this sense of looking tough. And many people actually start sounding cocky and arrogant and, just not fun to be with, okay? That's not the idea here. You see, posture is more about your belief. It's more about your mindset, and that's what transfers. As you're talking, as you're presenting your idea, presenting your business opportunity, your prospects can see that you know what you're saying and you have 100% confidence in what you're saying. The problem with most people that come into network marketing is, especially newcomers, is for most of them, they're just testing the waters, and yet they believe or they hope that it will be successful, but they're not too sure. And once you go to the table with that kind of mindset, your prospect can smell that. So you probably have heard of success being more about the person you need to become before you can attract that success. That's just how it is in network marketing, and that's how it is in posture. You don't need to wait till you are a multimillionaire before you have the posture of a multimillionaire. So you need to have that posture first and bring that posture to the table, and it's actually that posture and that confidence that is going to attract the leaders that you desire to work with, the leaders that you want to build your business with. So posture helps you control the conversation. So a good way to know if you are in control of the conversation is who's asking the questions. If you're doing a presentation and your prospect is the one asking the questions, then your prospect is in charge. So the person who ask the questions controls the conversation. Have that at the back of your mind. The person who asks the questions controls the conversation. So a good way to keep your posture and make sure you're the one in charge of the conversation is to be the one asking the questions. And don't just ask any question for the fun of it. You know, when you sit down to show your idea to someone, you should start by building rapport. And make sure you're the one asking the questions. You know, ask them about their family, about their workplace, how long have they been working, what do they like best about their work, what do they hate most about their work, what are their goals, what are their dreams, how determined are they to pursue their dreams, you know, what would they do if time and money were not an issue. Questions like that are very great in building rapport quickly and getting them to open up so that you can identify their pain points, which also gives you the confidence to introduce your problem, your product as a solution to their problem. So you see where asking the question comes in. And once you can do that, even if you are a newbie and you don't even have any experience, you automatically position yourself as the expert. And that's everything posture has to be is all about here, is positioning yourself as the authority in that business. Okay, they need to know that you are the authority, you know what you're doing. And even if you're not the multimillionaire, but you can actually guide them and show them how to get, you know, to their goals. So the other thing about posture is it's a choice. You know, you're going to decide, okay, you're going to ultimately decide if you're going to have posture or not. Are you going to lead from a position of fear or a position of faith? You know, are you going to come to the table hoping for them to join, or are you sure that they will join if it's the best thing for them? And are you going to make them see that that you can actually help them? You know, prospects want you to tell them how you're going to help them achieve their goals. Not just telling them they can make money, but they need to see how you can be the one to hold them and actually guide them to that goal. Okay, and if you can do that, you know, your posture starts to develop, and they see you as your authority. Just doing that, telling them how you can, you working there, if they work directly with you, plugging them, you know, into the team and the system, but you can actually help them to get to this goal. So if it's maybe they need to make $500 extra per month, you know, to pay off some debt, or they need $10,000 a month income to be financially free, you can assure them that this system that you're working with can actually help them get there. Yeah, so you need to make that choice. Okay, it's not just about having hope. Okay, I like to say that, you know, posture and success in network marketing has a lot to do with your faith. And faith is different from hope, because faith has substance. You know, faith is based on something. So if you're just hoping they would join, if you're wishing they would join, you know, just show them the idea, show them the presentation, and hope they say yes. I hate to disappoint you, but you won't get so many people, you know, joining your team. But if you have faith, okay, you believe that this is the best solution for their needs. Obviously, you've identified their pain points, and now you know that your service or your product or your team and your company, with their commitment, can get them to that goal. And that's what produces your faith. But you see, the thing about that is, before you can actually develop this faith and develop this posture, you need to have something. You know, there has to be a base, there has to be a substance, you know. And what is this substance? It's how much have you educated yourself about your product? If you don't know what your product can do, if you don't know the benefits, if you don't know how it changes lives, if you don't have the stories of, you know, other people that have been successful with your business, people that have testimonies about your product, you know, maybe you have a weight loss product and you have people that have lost, you know, how many pounds within 6 months or within 3 weeks, you know, you have some wonder stories and you have some, you know, some stories that they can relate with. If you're talking to a doctor, maybe you have stories because you've attended events, you have attended trainings, you have stories that you can pick up from and show them that, you know, someone in their shoes has actually achieved the success. So, you know, the first thing that I would say you should do is start educating yourself about your business. Educate yourself more. The more you know, the more knowledgeable you are about your business, the easier it is to show confidence, because you know exactly that. If you're talking to a doctor, for instance, you know a doctor that has had success with your business. So you know without a shadow of doubt that they can actually have the same success. You know the compensation plan. You don't have to know everything in the books, but you need to have a pretty good working knowledge of your business, and that brings more posture to you on the table. So the last thing I'll say here is back to leading the conversation. I usually approach my presentations like I'm interviewing someone. Okay, so I'm not needing them to join my team. I'm actually interviewing them to see if they qualify to be on my team, and that's a whole lot of pressure. That's a different ball game from what thousands of other network marketers are doing out there. So when I'm sitting across the table, after I build rapport, I'm asking questions that are qualifying them. Okay, I'm asking how determined are they, in building, in achieving success. One question I actually like to ask is, on a scale of 1 to 10. Right, 0 being not interested and 10 being 100% laser focused and determined to achieve your goals, how would you rate yourself in terms of determination? Okay, and a lot of people say, oh, I'm a 10, I'm a 9, but you see, that actually qualifies people. And I've actually had people tell me maybe 5, and honestly, when I tell people that have told me 5 or even 6, I tell them, you know, maybe they just shouldn't bother, because I'm looking for people that are self-motivated. I'm looking for people that are hungry. They're tired of their current situation, and they want to, they want to break into the next level by all means. Okay, and they're ready to put the commitment in and give you whatever it takes to get to that level. Those are the kinds of people I'm looking to work with. And once someone tells me they're an 8 or 9 or 10, they're more closer to that goal. So I ask questions like that. I actually have a set of about 5 questions that I ask like that, and I ask them. Another question is like, how many hours a week can you spend, or are you willing to invest in building your business part time? Right? I ask questions like, how much, would be significant for you, would make a difference in your life, that we can shoot within the next 6 months to 12 months. You know, how much is that? Is that $1,000 monthly income? Is that $5,000 monthly income? You see, that starts to show them that, hey, this guy knows what he's doing, and he can actually take me, to this income. So those are ways I build posture. And I even go all the way to ask, how much are you willing to invest in yourself on a monthly basis? Then I know if they are more likely to attend events. I mean, I from that point, I'm sifting the leaders, the eagles from the chickens, as my mentor Matt Morris would say. So, I mean, that's how I build posture. And just to do a quick recap, it's just your mindset. It's the way you see it. Okay. In summary, if you wish they will join, they will smell that. If you hope they will join, they'll smell that. But if you go to the table with the belief and the mindset that you're bringing the best, and you're doing them a favor, and you're not even needing them to join you, you're more likely to sign them up. And if you get an objection and you actually tell them, for example, someone tells you they want to think about it, and instead of saying, oh, what's there to think about, that's what most people say, like, what's there to think about? Is it the product? Is it how to lose weight? Is it how to travel? Is it how to look fine? Or what, to make money? What's there to think about? But that's from a position of neediness. You're trying to convince them that they need to join. But when someone tells you they need to think about it, and you tell them, you know what, take all the time you need. We have hundreds of videos online. You can knock yourself out and watch everything and make sure you're really ready to start a business with me before you come back to me. And because I really want to be sure that anybody I'm working with is 100% committed and ready to crush it in their business. If you tell them that kind of response, they start to think that, hey, this guy is not, he's not needing me, and you're actually taking the opportunity away from them, they're more likely to join. You see, it works in reverse. If you have this confidence and you do the takeaway, when they object, you also object, they're more likely to draw back to you. And I mean, I hope you got value from those tips. Those are just some ideas around posture. Definitely, with time and with experience, you'll be able to build more posture in your business. But for now, just take these tips and apply them, and I wish you the best of luck. So, one thing that's very important is actually having the team system in place, and not just, you know, not just for making money, for doing anything. Okay, and if you're watching this video and you actually you don't have a system in place, okay, because you see a lot of things you do, especially when you're using the internet and with the power that the internet has, you need to know how to leverage that internet, you know, and the system that automate a lot of this the things you need to do in your business to make more sales. If you don't have a system in place, okay, click the link below this video and get my system that top earners use to build their business online almost automatically. Okay, we have automated systems that are just plug and play that even newbies can use and start making money as fast as possible. So click the link below this video and you'll be able to get that right away. With that being said, thanks for taking a look at this video. If you got value out of it, please feel free to share, you know, with others to help them build more posture and make more money. And I'll see you on the next show. Take care and cheers.